Hey, what's up YouTube, and welcome to Rigging Sonic Game Version Part 1. Now, I said this was gonna be the lazy way, so let's get it started. Shift A, Armature, and Human Metric. Alt G, make sure this guy, when you import him, yeah, he's gonna be huge. So just scale him down, and Control A, and scale. Same with our rig, we're gonna go to viewport display. Let's see, viewport display. Oh yeah, turn this off. We don't want wiggle armature. Okay, viewport display. Ah, it's right there. Okay, make sure this is in front and tap into edit mode. Scale this down a little bit more. There. Step into edit mode and select these bones. Well, box select these and just scale it up. Just make sure we got all of them. Scale it up. See. That's not right. Let's try to put these into place, then just start pushing these down because Sonic does not have a neck. So I'm not going to delete those, otherwise I'm not going to be able to use the rigify. Okay, so press Z and this bone right there, we're not going to need it. X, delete bones. Then I'm going to turn this on. And the whole face rig, I'm going to delete it. X, bones. Just like that. But click these, X, bones. Well done. Now, top view. Well, delete these as well, and then just bring these down a little bit. These we can bring up, this one we can bring up, this one we can bring up. I'm not gonna need that. Just bring these down a little bit. Okay, just bring these down along with these parts of the arms. About there, that should be good. Yep. Right. Shift is cursor to selected. I've got this on a shortcut, so I can just say cursor to selected. And then actually both of these, control cursor to selected, and make sure you, from melting point you go to 3D cursor. And just select these and press R. No, not E, R. There we go. And then again, set it right there, take this out. And rotate that. Okay, wait. Let's just bring this in a bit. Q. Because it's selected, like I said, that's just for me. Select these and rotate them. Oh, come on, rotate these up. Might have to bring these up a bit more. Rotate and just bring that up a bit more. Thank you. Now I'm gonna go back to Maiden Point. Alright. Try to put this right in the middle of this. Something like that. Make sure this is straight. It's at zero. Just like that. And then just for this part, just bring it back a little bit. Now, we want these. Hit S, scale. Bring it back. Well, actually, we don't want this bone at all. Scale these up. Bring them up. Or out. Whatever floats your boat. Take this, rotate it, put it into place. Rotate it, put it into place, scale it down. Scale it down, put it into place. Actually just do this from top view. I'm gonna do this one first. Okay, just press L on this. Rotate it, put it into place. Take these, rotate it, put it into place, scale it down a bit. Okay, now I'm gonna select all of these, every one of them, except for the thumb. Let's try that again. SZ0. So now we can just bring them up. Then select these parts right there. And GZ. And then these as well. We're just gonna bring these up. Okay, so. Okay, go back into top view. Actually, this one is not in the right place. I'm gonna go from global to local, normal. Click these and then just turn this on and just move it back on the Y. Now this one is almost in place. I just want to rotate these a little bit more. Back, rotate. If you got this one, rotate, bring it back somewhere around there. Bring this in a bit, rotate, bring it in. And I just realized my screencast keys are not enabled. My bad, guys. So let's just do that real quickly. Okay, so there you got my screencast keys. Okay, so I'm gonna start by moving these into place. Try to get these straight. If you want to get them straight as possible, you can just S, X, and 0, because it's gonna straighten them out on their normal. It's X, 0. It's X, 0. bro. And for the time, I'm not gonna do that. Okay, going back to top view now. Check this out a little bit. Check this back a little bit. I'm looking at these now. Just to get a bit better to form on this. That should be good. Let's do the thumb. Rotate it a bit. Set it down. Move it into place. Go to front view. Make sure that it's in place like this. Okay, go to top view. I'm just gonna move this in and just bring it out a little bit. Okay, so the fingers are good. I'm happy with that. Except for these. These can go down a little bit. So, D, Z, and Z again. Just bring them out. Z, Z, and 0. Just to straighten them out. You can just bring this down a bit. And then we can just move this out. Okay, go to front view, and now for the legs. I'm just gonna move this up first. And just because it is selected, set this to 3D cursor, and select these and rotate. Just like that. And you can select this one, is it at 0? Okay, so why is that not working? Let's just go to global quickly. Is it 0? Oh, because I'm still on 3D cursor. So let's just go back to meeting point. Is it 0? Select this one, just move it out. This one, just move it up. This one, let's go back to normal. Move it up. Go to side view, and I wanted to, let's just have a look. Say from around there. So I'm just gonna move this up a little bit more. Actually, this is a toe, so. Yeah, that should be good. This guy and put it by the heel. So this is basically where you want to deform it from, to pivot it from. I think somewhere around here might be good. I think this can come down a little bit more. Okay. Maybe this can go up a little bit more. And then the hips, move them down. Oh my goodness, what's the time? Oh my lord, this is the second time I'm recording this, so bear with me, I'm a little drowsy. Okay, so I think that should be good. This, I don't think that's properly in place, so just move it on that axis. I think I can rotate this on the Y a little bit. I want it to rotate that way. Okay, so cool. Now, excuse me. Now, this is what we're going to do. Click this and go to the Rigify buttons and generate rig. That's not right because I didn't apply this. Control A and scale. No, it didn't work. There we go. So select this and select this. Control P with automatic weights. And then Control T and have a look. Scale this. Looks like it's working. Yep. Can rotate these. Okay, that looks good. Okay, the full targets, they're a little bit out. Don't know why that would be the case. Actually, bones, let's see what's going on. SX0. Just make sure you got the front view, you don't see the X. Well, the Z. That was just weird. So let's try that again. Rigify. Generate rig. And Control P with automatic weights. Control Tab. Yo. Control Tab. Not sure if Tab, Control Tab. That looks good. That looks good. That's not right. I want this to deform as well, so we can fix that up. That looks good. All right, and then Control Tab and this mouth. I don't want to parent it to the rig, so I'm gonna select the rig. And because I had the head selected last, I'm gonna say Control P. Well, absolutely not. Control Tab and Control P and bone, just like that. So when I select this one, Control Tab, and I rotate this, the mouth is gonna rotate with it. And you can see his eyes is closed, so we're gonna, well, his eyelids are closed, so we're gonna fix that as well. So I'm just gonna do this and hide it because I still have a few extra things I have to test. That rotates right, that rotates right, that looks good. And also, if you want this to follow the body, let's just go to the armature display and in front, and then let's just press. I can't remember what this is, but anyway, you want to get to your items, and you're gonna look for. Oh, IK parent. And set it to 2. So I'm just gonna show you. That one is following. If I select this one and I set this one to 2, it's gonna follow. You can do the same with the feet. Cool. Now we got the rig. Now we need some shape keys. So, tab into edit mode. You can see I already have these selected. But these are the old age. I want these. These are the ones I wanna edit. So, go into your vertex tab. The one with a triangle, upside down triangle, and shape keys, and call this eyelids. Now tap into edit mode and set your 3D cursor about there. Actually, we can just hide this, or we can go into wireframe. No, we can hide this. Oh, hide. Okay, so I want my 3D cursor about in the middle of this, so right there, and Q, cursor to select it, so L, and make sure you're on 3D cursor, is it? And now when I do this, from there we want, so let's just have a look. I'm just gonna go into sculpt mode, sculpt this in. No, don't go into sculpt mode because you're gonna sculpt both of these. Okay, I'm just gonna remove that and add a new one. So it is it. Just trying to see where the problem is. Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to make two shape keys for this. But let's start again. So, two shape keys. First one. Tab. Is it? Bring it out. Thank you. make sure that you turn on proportional editing and make sure this is connected only. There we go. Up there. I'm just trying to get this to a point where it doesn't clip. And then the next one, I can make another shape key from this. Pro L is it. Almost there. We're trying to get this into place for a done clip. Okay, so now we should be able to bring this down. Okay, so that's not working. Okay, I'm gonna try this one more time, but before I do that, just gonna remove this and go into my edit, all the way to the bottom, and auto mirror. So now we got a nicely mirrored object. But I don't think I wanna mirror the whole thing. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this, get the right one. Come on. And hit P and selection. And then we can do the auto mirror. And set it to the top. Just like that. Okay, tab into edit mode. Alt H. Now we want this guy. Okay, so that could work. With A, S, and Z. Make sure I'm normal and just go to this. and I forgot again to add the shape keys. What's going on with me? Okay. Add the shape keys, 1, 2, 3. Tap into edit mode, and then just go to the first one. Okay, so now I think this one would be. So let's just try this again. Try to bring this down. Second shape key, hit tab, hit A, and S, Y. Okay, and then we have to okay, that looks good. And it should still be parented. Control tab. Apparently not that well. Let's see what's going on. So that would make sense. Okay, so I'm just gonna delete this object. Keep that. It's already got the shape keys, and I'm gonna import that again. Import, and I think it was a day file. R, and you see what I meant about this thing is way too big. RX90, just gonna delete this, scale this down, Alt-B. I don't know why, but just delete the bones and cut it down. Now I'm just going to go into front view and make sure my model lines up with my armature. I can also Alt H just to unhide these to make sure. Okay, hide. And I know I'm gonna have a bit of a problem here because okay, just take these away, all of them. Okay. Control tab, Alt R, Alt D. Make sure this is in place. So this thing doesn't have to go up anymore. And that should be good. And then tab into edit mode. Control L, X, pages. Hit A, S, merge by distance. Is here versus remove. Okay, S and tries to quads. There we go. And then parent it. Control P with automatic weights. Quick fix. Everything still works fine. That's what we want. Okay, so now I'm gonna make some more, a few extra shape keys for this. And also take away normal, go to global. The second one, I'm going to bring these down. Oh, actually just the one. It's enough relative. Why the heck? This one that's messing around now. Just take it away. I'm gonna try that again. So the first shape key, loosen this up a bit. Second shape key, and this up. So obviously this is gonna be a problem. So go into edit mode, look at the last shape key, and then just scale it down a little bit more and move it away, out of the way, something like that. Generative relative. Now I'm gonna edit the quilt a bit. Okay, so now we got the quills. That should be good. Now it's for animating him. Let's see how much time we have left to animate this guy. I've got about 43 minutes now. So now it's for animation. Control tab. And I'm just gonna rotate these a bit more inwards. Actually use these. So before I do that side, I'm just gonna start by moving these down. That one back, that one forward, rotate it up. So first of all, I'm only gonna do the feet first. I'm gonna insert that and just select the skiing and just go for whole character. Actually, just the location rotation and insert that. And go to 9, Alt G, Alt R. R, insert. I just want to see this is the foot that's coming forward, so I'm gonna move that one up, maybe just move this one up a bit, rotate, GZ, just like that, and maybe just insert everything. So now frame 20, this one has to come forward, Alt R, rotate it up, this one goes back, maybe not that high, this one goes back and rotate this. So I'll insert, I just want to see, I'm going to take this one and I'm going to control C and copy location. And then I'm going to control V and okay, so that's not working. Control C, copy location. I gotta know why. Okay, so there was something we can do with this. Where was it? Oh, and I should go to my dev sheet for this. Dev sheet. Dev sheet is a lot easier to animate with, unless you prefer to, you know, do something like this. Where was it again? Yeah, something like this. Dev sheet in the bottom and timeline on the top. But for now, I still need to copy this. V, Control C, Control V. And insert. And now we can just select all of these and Shift D. And what was it? What time of a current frame? I don't wanna see. Control C, Control V, okay, Shift D. And then these two has, they have to do this, this, okay, this one is on 30, this one 30, this one 40. So there's something wrong with this one. Okay, only these two. I only want to copy these two. 50. And just bring this one close to 30, this one close to 40. Shield R. Z and rotate. And insert. Okay, so now we need some extra poses here where it actually starts moving where it's not supposed to. So rotate this. Easy. Alright, let's move this out a little bit. Insert, and if you want to, you can actually go for king and auto keyframe and auto keyframe. There we go. I think this is where the heel will come down, this way the... Good, and this is where you start rotating. GC. GC. Alt R. And let's try that again. Now I need to do the same on this side. About there, Alt R. This one, CZ. Alt R. Z. Then just select this. What was it? Okay, so now let's have a quick look. Bring the end back. Now it looks like he's walking until we take everything and just scale it down from 1. That looks pretty much good. Okay, so now for these, I'm gonna delete the keyframes, so the rest is still gonna be there because these I actually want them to move back. I'm just gonna get a nice pose for this. Get a nice fist. Okay, so make sure I'm in normal. And then rotate. And rotate this on the normal. still held it down a bit more. Yeah, the thumb has to rest it down a bit, fill it in, something like that. And rotate. So let's try to make a nice twist for this one. Okay, rotate, back, okay, so now we're gonna select both of these, easy. PZ. And Shift D. Okay, so now I'm gonna do the same with this. Hit A, X, clean keyframe, X delete keyframes. I'm gonna rotate it like this. This one also, X delete keyframes. I'm gonna rotate it up. And I can see there's something weird going on. I don't like it. First of all, select this one, and maybe one of these. Okay, and also everything. Let's do this one on frame 0. Okay, that's good. It's supposed to be there. Okay, so now maybe just one of these. Go to the next frame. Z. And just copy this. We'll see. V and just copy this one, Shift D, Shift D, and Alt A. Now let's start again with the head. Go to the center frame. Then just copy this one, Shift D. Okay, and select this for now. So this one would be fine. Now, this is what we're looking at, this leg. Now I want to animate the quills. So, frame 1, frame 6. And frame 1 all the way back. You can maybe bring this up a bit more. Let's see. Okay. Let's go all the way. Okay, so now something we need to do with the feet. When they're in this position, one should be at the back, control tab. One should be in the front. Just like that. A little too much. Awesome. And now, because I am in UPBGE, don't know if you have your BBGE, but I have your BBGE. Now I'm gonna select this and just give it a logic editor and give it a keyboard. Before I do that, I'm gonna have to go to my animation editor, and key one is gonna be go anim and rig action is gonna be run. So I'm just gonna put that there, and this one I'm just gonna put it there. See if I go into my timeline now and just give it one extra frame. Okay. Okay, before I put in any other animations, I'm gonna tab into my edit mode, well, control tab, and I'm gonna make a new animation. So, I'm gonna turn this off, so I can't animate anymore. So, Alt-G, Alt-R. I do not with the hands. Alt-G, Alt-R. Alt-G, Alt-R. Okay, so rotate this. GZ. GZ. And rotate. Bring it in. And I'm gonna insert everything. And make sure I'm in timelines. I'm not gonna need this, it's delete keyframes. And then just take this one, GZ. And click this one, 50. Okay, so I'm gonna need a bit longer of an animation for this. So I'm gonna maybe make it 20. Hit A, control tab. And bring this one up to 20, this one up to 10. Okay, and then I'm gonna make another animation from this one. So I'm gonna start it at 20. Just like that, and end it at 40. No, at least 60. So, I'm 35. GZZ. Rotate. So I'm not gonna look at these right now, hide them. Okay, so I don't want to be a normal, maybe not local, global for now. Just trying to clean this up a bit so that I can actually see the armature I'm trying to work with. My gosh, it's already past 5 and I'm working today. Okay, so.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
Okay, there I can play. Sorry about that. I can't play that music. I hope I'm not getting Okay, so. Okay, so I'm just trying to get this properly into place. So I need this one.
Excuse me.
Okay, so I need to copy the pose. I still can't remember where. Oh, come on. Control C. Copy pose. Control B. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to my animation tab thingy, and I know that was wrong, but right rig, and now I've got a new pose. This one and idle. Idle loop and do that. So I'm gonna do this and invert keyboard and invert all keys. And when I invert all keys, I'm gonna have a state to pop up. I need a state, just like this, and I want to set it to state 2, and on state 2, I'm gonna add a timer or a delay, let's say about 100 seconds. Material repeat is set, and also so, and then state. Okay, so this will be the idle state. So on this state, I'm gonna have an always and an action. Go action and run armature. No, not armature. Actually, yes. Action, and with this action, we want this to loop end. Well, actually, loop stop. Now we're just gonna bring the blend in a little bit. And this is the idle loop, just like that. So when I press Ctrl Tab and press P, oh, and also I want this to start at this. And also the time. I need the time. I think it ended 60 frames. Alright, mistaken. No, it stopped at 73. Just like that. If I hit P now, should have won. For some reason this isn't working. Ah, there we go. Okay, so now what I can do is this loop. I think I got this on maybe 20. I think that was 20, I think it was. Is it 20? Yep. Okay, so now we got the idle, and this is really gonna stop irritating me. I'll feed you a parent. Then tab into edit mode, well, control tab. Let's just go to timeline real quickly. Let's turn off this. Alt G, Alt R. Then I want to bring in this. Now, I know this video is going on a bit longer than expected, but what is this one? Want this done before I go to work, so tab out of edit mode, well, control tab. Control tab. Select this bone, control tab. Select this thing. Well, actually select the armature first and select this guy and update weight base. Okay, so it's the wrong armature. Let's just have a quick look. Okay, these are not the default buttons. That's not working. It should actually control B with automatic weights. And then make sure I've got these. And control. Take this one, hold tab. So. Think that it would be fine. The great thing about YouTube Music, eh? Alright, so, object mode. Control tab. Well, control tab. Bring this back. Control tab. And rotate. And apparently the nose is not parented. Something else is So let's see what this is. This bone right here, this is Dev Spine 6. Control tab. Let's go to this and make sure this, that this is Dev into edit mode and assign. And just making sure nothing else can go tap, okay, tap. And armature, let's bring these back. Go tap and rotate. I don't know what the hell that is. Okay, so. And now this loop would be on 20. And I've still got a problem with this. Okay, just tap into edit mode with this and go into your timeline. We'll be right back. excuse me. Now just copy this one right here, and now it should be done. Go back. Okay, there is something wrong there. Now I'm gonna go back into my Logic Editor. This one, Logic Editor. Click the armature. Click this one, and I think. Yep. I'm gonna make this maybe 5. Then on the last one, we're gonna have exactly the same one, the animation. Okay, so when we're here, we're gonna need something more. We're gonna need another delay. And delay that goes maybe 100 as well. And then action, or actually a state. And it's gonna go to this bit right there, and have an always and an action. Just close this down. Connect this up. This would be idle. To start at 20 and ends at 70. Okay, and then we're gonna see. So, and now we just need a what was it again? Oh, not scene state. The state never works like that. Actuator. perfect. It's a lot of stuff in this bit. Okay, what else we can do is just go to your debug properties, just turn on debug properties, should be familiar as well. Edit. Debug menu. Okay, there's Vera there, I don't know it. Good year. It flips my screen. Simplify. Give up properties. And then just turn states on. My turn with states. The 3, 4. The state on state 4. 1, 2. State 4, I think that's a bit too long, so I'm gonna make this 5. It is connected. See what happens. Okay, so state 3, there's another mistake. another problem here. I didn't. This is not long enough. From state 2 to state 2, so I think it's here. Okay, well, I'll fix that when I have time. I'm just gonna show you quickly. Let's turn this off. What it's gonna look like if it runs. And then I'm done. Action. And run. And I think that was how long. Gonna go check. That's 12 frames. Why do I keep looking for this? And I'm still starting with that. motion, something like that. Now we got a nice motion blur going with it. Steps, we can bring it up. Okay, so there we got Sonic running. So I'm just gonna save this because I'm gonna do a few extra animations on this when I actually start again. But thanks for watching, guys. If you liked it, give it a like. I know this was a shit long video, but I hope you learned something from it, animation and all. And also, please give me a like and a sub. I just see it now. Okay, please give me a like and a sub, guys. I would really appreciate it. Try to get the channel to grow. Really, I'm trying to get the channel to grow. And also, you guys must have an awesome day. It's 6 in the morning here, and it's time for me to go to sleep. Have a nice day. Cheers, guys.